In this video, I will be reviewing assembly and disassembly of the syringe, along with aspiration and sharps disposal. So the first thing we want to do when assembling our syringe is we want to retract the thumb ring and pull back on the piston to the fullest extent. This is going to allow us to insert our cartridge into the large window. And we want to insert our cartridge with the rubber stopper side down and the diaphragm or the needle penetrating end pointing up towards the needle adapter. So pull all the way back on the thumb ring, fully retract that piston, hold that into place, and then drop that cartridge in with the rubber stopper side pointing towards the harpoon. Because the harpoon is what is going to engage that rubber stopper, which is going to allow us to aspirate. So at this point, we want to go ahead and engage our harpoon. So to do that, what I like to do is I like to hold the cartridge in place with my thumb on my non-dominant hand. And then with my dominant hand, you're going to push in on the thumb ring firmly and slightly twist. And then I suggest that two times, push in and twist. And then if you pull back on the thumb ring, you'll see now it's pulling back on the entire cartridge. And so we know that our rubber stopper and our harpoon have been engaged. So at this point, we can go ahead and attach our needle. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my needle here. And I'm just going to twist off the end. And that's going to reveal the needle penetrating end or the diaphragm penetrating end. So I'm going to go ahead and insert that and just try and insert that into the holder as steady as possible. And then you want to just kind of push firmly down and then thread that needle on as straight as you can. So here we can see on this needle, we have the red dot again, which is going to indicate where our bubble is. Once you have your needle attached, you want to test your armamentarium to make sure that your equipment, everything's working properly. Again, you don't want to get into the tissue and then realize your anesthetic's not coming out because then you have to go back in and penetrate again. So you want to avoid minimize the number of penetrations as much as possible. So at this point, I'm going to loosen the cap. So I'm just going to set my syringe down. And so with one hand, I'm going to just kind of loosen the cap here. And then once it's loose, I'm just going to slide this up so you can see how I'm going to grab on. I'm just going to grab onto my syringe, and then I'm just going to lift up to come out of the cap, and then I'm just going to gently, again, make sure that the anesthetic's coming out, so we can see there's a drop coming out nicely there. So now I'm just going to go ahead and recap. I don't want to expel a bunch of anesthetic, just a little bit to make sure that it's functioning properly. So I'm going to insert into the cap, and then once my needle is inside the cap, I can bring my other hand in to secure that back on. So that is a one-handed technique. So that's what we want to use always when we are uncapping and recapping our needle to ensure safety. Anytime you go to reload the syringe, say your harpoon becomes disengaged, you always want to remove your needle. If you have to change out your cartridge, be it you got a positive aspiration, you need more anesthetic, or your harpoon becomes disengaged. Because otherwise, if you don't remove your needle and try to engage your harpoon, you're going to just dispel a bunch of anesthetic unnecessarily. So always remove your needle if you need to remove your cartridge or re-engage your harpoon. As far as aspiration goes, aspiration is just a very slight negative pressure. Again, once we get to our target in the tissue, we want to aspirate to make sure we're not in a blood vessel. So So to do that, it's just a small amount of negative pressure on the thumb ring. And you saw I just made an adjustment there to ensure that my large window was as clear as possible. So you can see if I turn my syringe around, that barcode is towards the back of the syringe or the small window. So you can see, you know, we have a pretty large amount of metal coping right here that prevents us from being able to see the top part of our cartridge where that blood is going to come into the cartridge if we do get positive aspiration. So yeah, we want to make sure that this large window here is as clear as possible because this is usually at the top here near that metal cap is where we generally see that positive aspiration come into the cartridge. So I'm just going to tap with a one-handed technique again. So let me show you that loosening. And then I'm just going to grab here. And you'll see I'm just going to lift my hand up. That way I come out of the cap without contaminating my needle. So for aspiration, again, it's just going to be, turn this towards the camera, a slight negative pressure on the thumb ring. So just a small amount of negative pressure like that. If you have a large aspiration, you might get a lot of bubbles coming into the cartridge, so you want to try and prevent the air from coming in, but you may get some air in the cartridge. And if you do get air in the cartridge, you just want to try and tip the syringe upside down, to get the air to kind of come to the top, and then you can try and expel the air at the top of the syringe. Here's a little bit of this closing solution in a cup. So I'm going to try and see if you can see that come into a cartridge there. Oops, I just disengaged my heart wound. So if that happens, I would scoop up, come out of the tissue. Obviously, if you got to your target and your harpoon became disengaged, you would want to come out of the tissue because at that point, you're not able to aspirate. So you'd have to come out of the tissue and then remove your needle and then re-engage your harpoon. If you're using a lot of negative pressure, too much maybe on your thumb ring, sometimes that can happen when you aspirate, you disengage your harpoon. Really it is just a slight amount. It doesn't require that much pressure back on the thumb ring to draw in any amount of blood into the cartridge if you happen to be in a vessel. So just keep that in mind. Just a slight amount. Let's see if we can get some of this dissolving solution to come in here again. There you can kind of see. So that's a little bit like what a positive aspiration might look like. The dissolving solution coagulates a little bit more. Blood tends to mix with the anesthetic and blends a little bit more and will kind of fill up the cartridge. And then again, if that happens, you just come out of the tissue. You're going to remove your needle and change out your cartridge. At that point, you want to change both your needle and cartridge because you could have blood in the lumen of the needle and get a false positive. So to disassemble, you want to remove the needle first. So you can see I'm kind of unscrewing the needle. Sometimes the needle in the diaphragm will get kind of stuck. So I sometimes twist it just to get it to come out. And then you want to just use a one-handed technique again to put this into the shark's container. I'm going to grab my makeshift shark container here. My apologies, I don't have an actual sharp here, but this is my makeshift sharps container. And so I just want to take it over to sharps, drop it in. I don't want to touch sharps at all because anything on the outside of the sharps is probably contaminated. Try not to touch that with your gloved hands. And if you do, just change out your gloves. At this point, I'm just going to pull all the way back on my piston, try and disengage my harpoon from that rubber stopper, and then you can just turn your large window down and then drop out the cartridge, kind of drops out into your hand. And at that point, you can just drop the cartridge into the sharps container. With a one-handed technique, obviously you're not going to be holding the sharps container. One other thing I want to quickly show, so some individuals prefer to use the protector parts, so I'll just give you a quick demonstration of how to use the protector card. It should be like to have that to kind of prop your needle up. There's a couple ways to do this. In my opinion, the simplest thing to do, because the examiners, if you're using this for the testing agencies like RUB, they tend to be a little sticklers about any fingers going on the word side of the card. So you don't want to put any fingers on this side of the card where the words are, because this is where the needle comes out, and that puts you at risk for a stick. The protector card is meant to be a safety device, and so if you're not using it properly, then they consider that poor technique, and so that could be a fail. So you don't want something silly like that to affect you if you are taking an exam. So same thing with the protector cards. You just want to loosen using a one-handed technique when you're going to grab your syringe for use. I like to kind of balance the card about halfway on the cap. That way, when I try to uncap, it kind of tips back. So you want to just loosen again, with a one-handed technique there. And then I like to pick up the syringe and bring my hand up and tip the card back and then draw my needle out. Otherwise, you risk the card tipping forward when you come out, and that can contaminate your needle. And if you don't notice it, again, in the examining world, that is considered a fail. And so then you saw upon recapping there, I inserted, and then once the needle was in, I can bring my other hand in and secure, but I have to come from behind the card. I can't secure here. All fingers have to go behind the card. So one more time with that. Loosen. Sorry, these ones are a little tricky to loosen with one hand. And then when I go to grab it, tilt back, and then lift up and come out with the needle. To recap, you can come in one-handed. Once the needle's in there, I can bring my other hand in to secure. Okay, so that's uncapping and recapping. At the end, if you had to change out your armamentarium for some reason in the middle of the procedure, my suggestion is just to take the card off before you do your sharps disposal, because that eliminates that whole confusion about where your fingers have to be on this side of the card. Because I can show you, if you're going to leave the card on there, again, this is how you have to remove it. Fingers always have to be behind the card. And then when you take it to sharps, here's my sharps there. When you take it to sharps, you literally have to set it on there, because again, I can't touch any side of here. So I can't come over here with this hand and touch that. I just have to set it on the sharps container, and then push this through, and that's it. But now this card is contaminated, so you don't want to pick it up and use it again. So again, if you want to use the card again, my suggestion is to just take the card off before you remove your needle, and then the disposal of your needle is the same. So just take the card off, remove your needle, and then just drop it in the shark. Boom, that's it. Okay. All cartridges and all needles that were used on a patient go into a shark container.